Previously, housemates got personal.
I've never wanted to snog the face off of a current housemate.
I have never used strange sexual toys.
What are you had?
Watermelon.
A watermelon! Tonight, Gigi gets physical.
You have got quite smooth knees, I guess.
Day 61, 10:20 a.m. Corin and Mario are at the carousel. Last night, during a drinking game, JJ indicated that he didn't fancy Corin.
I give JJ his brew this morning when I walked in. Dave was like, oh, you love him, don't you? Look at her straight in and giving you a brew. Oh, don't cringeable apple left there. Do not even say that.
Did JJ say anything?
No. Oh, yeah, thanks, babe.
Joe, Steve, Josie and JJ are in the bedroom talking about relationships.
I think cheating on someone is probably one of the most selfish things you can do. To put someone through that hurt and misery.
For no particular reason, apart from your own selfishness.
Yeah.
And you know what's pathetic? When they get caught.
Oh, God.
Wait, crocodile tears.
Oh, God.
It meant nothing to me.
Yeah, but if you want to, like, do you know what I mean, go mess around, don't be with me. Don't be with that person.
I had it both ways, I had it.
It ain't good either way, is it?
No. I'd never do it again, ever.
Once a cheat, always a cheat.
Fuck off. Fucking bitch.
I reckon that people can learn their lesson.
I would never ever do that to a girl again. I was cheated on before I'd done it, so I never thought I'd do it anyway. But I learned a lesson, definitely, so.
Do you think you might sleep around when you get out of here? Are you a sleep
I don't think so.
Type?
I'm happy being single and stuff, but yeah, I've been a lad and I've been about and stuff.
I'm not saying sleep about, but you've got ages to settle yourself down.
Yeah. No, like if
you're
if,
very,
if
very mature for your age, aren't you,
Jim? Yeah, in
not
some
really.
Respects.
But if you if I'm proper involved with someone, if I feel like I'm seeing someone, like I wouldn't go, like I don't go on dates very often. But say I was like to take a girl out a few times, I really liked them. If I was just chilling with her for a bit, I wouldn't be doing that same thing with another girl and another girl around the same sort of time.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
Would you go out with a girl that your mates didn't think was that great looking?
Yeah, because that's not. That's not the main thing. If they're a nice person, nice person, funny, and my mates think that she'll do me right and I do, then do you know what I mean?
So you're saying there's a chance?
Ten:42 a.m.
I was never very good at English literature. I never understood verbs, nouns, adverbs.
It's English language.
Pronouns. Yeah, language, yeah, sorry. That was one of my weaker subjects.
Mm. What were your strong subjects?
I was pretty good at maths.
Yeah.
Religious education.
Oh, yeah, I bet you were good at that. I was really good at that as well, actually.
Metalwork. History. Mm. I got a certificate in history.
Wonderful.
I got twos, which I suppose would be equivalents of like B's these days. Lots of twos. Mediocrity.
Nah.
As per the rest of my life.
B's good now.
I can't be asked to move, but I've got to go running.
I think I'm quite wrong about Jay. Yesterday I thought he was.
Crack.
I'm totally wrong. Yesterday I thought he was a bit arrogant, but I think I only thought he was arrogant because. He didn't take a drink of his drink about Corin. I thought, you arrogant little bugger. But it's not arrogant, is it?
Is she all right with it now?
Yeah, she's all right. But when somebody like makes your mate feel like that, you think you get a bit protective, don't you? And you're like, right, yeah, no, bugger him, he's arrogant. But he actually isn't, is he? He's quite a sweet lad, actually, isn't he? Very sweet.
Like, I can be really nice, but then I've got a side to me that can...
I used to think John James was arrogant.
He's got a nice side, but he's still got an arrogant side. That's just his character, isn't it? Do you think he's changed?
John James? Mm. Yeah. From when he first came here, yeah.
Plus, there's no one to rile him up anyway, is there?
No. Oh, but he'll find himself.
Yeah.
As long as he don't try find me, I don't mind.
No, I think he's... I said to him yesterday, I said she can handle herself, right?
And what did he say?
Yeah, I know. Yeah, I know. I think she, if she wants to go, I think she'll go, yeah.
Is that what he said?
Yeah. And I said, yeah.
So I'm glad he knows I'm off his radar then.
Yeah.
I think if you weren't in the mix of it, we probably would have caught up by now.
You're joking, what about?
Just, we would have.
You reckon?
Yeah. Wonder what he would be like if he was at home in Australia with his own mates.
Yeah, that's what I wonder, is it? Because I wonder if he's, like, arrogant on the outside world, but... Yeah?
But people can change.
...1:51 PM. John James, Mario and Steve are in the kitchen.
Well, I walked into this house with a heart full of sadness, and most of that's gone now.
Well, that's good, isn't it?
Yeah. I'm full of hope again. As Florence and the Machine sang once, the dog days are over.
Mmm. They could be just around the fucking corner.
Yeah.
Actually.
Nah, I think it's too late in the day for anyone to, like, have a, like, massive romance.
Me too.
The only romance that's going to happen is between John and Jose.
Yeah.
And between Mario and Andrew.
Yeah, or between
well, fingers
those
crossed.
Two.
Or between Andrew and a trifle.
Well, Andrew is bi-curious.
I'm not bi-curious.
I've only been getting quite close to the avocados in the last couple of days. I hear there's a blossoming relationship between you and the Ecuadorian avocado.
You know what? If you're not man enough to play I Never, you can't comment, all right?
Not man enough, my friend. I just didn't want to embarrass myself and lose all my dignity like you guys did.
Excuse me, Dave.
What's that?
I find that comment offensive.
What's that?
What okay, well, if people are happy banging all this stuff out
that
there...
Game. Embarrassed ourselves and lost our dignity.
I think you did.
What, the game that's we just my opinion. Night? Yeah. Do you? Why?
Why? Because why would you want to wear all of your stuff between, like,
if I didn't
want to
say any
million
shit,
people?
I wouldn't have said that.
No one said anything bad.
I could be judgmental and pull out things that I might have seen you talk about or do and say that I think that's you, but I wouldn't. We were just playing a game.
I don't feel I embarrassed myself.
That's fine, I do. Forgot about the cameras. But
Andrew definitely did. I think probably some other people may have as well if they thought it was being aired live.
I just really couldn't care. If you're worried about shit that you're going to say in it, you come to the wrong place.
Yeah.
It's not I'm worried about what I say. I'm obviously willing to say stuff, but I just think there's certain things that are like, why would you want to wear that stuff out there? Do you know what I mean?
Saying that losing your dignity is quite a strong word.
Well, there's no point about worrying in it, because we can't change it now, can we, so... Yeah.
Oh, my God, it's The Rock! Oh, he's got him in the headlock!
...2:15 PM. Andrew has been called to the diary room.
Hello, Andrew.
Hello, big brother.
How are you?
Yeah, I'm really well, thank you.
Today, Big Brother would like to find out how close certain housemates really are.
How close they are? Okay, cool.
Big Brother would like to enlist your help in answering this question.
Brilliant. Well, I am somewhat of a scientist. Have a go, scientist, so...
In front of you is a scientist outfit. Please put it on.
Oh, brilliant. Oh, yay.
Most of the housemates are in the garden.
I wonder if you and John got matching bollocks as well.
Well, I got tiny bollocks.
I've got small ones. It's probably about a little bit. It's about probably about the size of this.
Really?
About that big.
No way.
I just felt it.
No, but that big.